Well, it doesn't make any odds now because my game has crashed.
Have you got a spare invite?
Luckily, I've got a... should have a spare invite. No, I don't anymore. Oh. They've all gone.
Oh, no.
No.
Right, I'll,
okay, well, I'm coming out this then. You're on your own, Amish, I'm afraid.
I can invite you for the race if you want.
Nah. I'll just... it's alright.
Okay, fine.
No, that's just unlucky. I think I know why it crashed anyway, so...
oh, right, I see.
Down. You still got the thingy, haven't you?
Sorry?
You know, I've got the speaky thing on now.
Yes, yeah. It's coming through on the stream at the moment.
Well, hello everybody, this is the AOR PC Split 1 featuring Hamish, because mine has blown up on me the game, so I can't commentate with you, unfortunately. It would have been a very nice thing to do, but oh well. I'm gonna pass over to Hamish, as he's going to be going through the qualifying session as it has already started, so I'm going to leave you in the capable hands now. So Hamish, the best of luck, and we'll be watching from the sidelines.
Yeah, cheers Ryan, welcome to the AOR
User disconnected from
round,
the
AOR round, whatever this is, 13, for the Belgium Grand Prix. Unfortunately, King Kodiak is not able to make it today. So I am going to be on my own, so this is not going to be very professional, but I hope that at least you guys will get a good insight of a race. So if you're looking forward to seeing the race, hopefully you'll be able to see it in full with me. I have no idea if my stream's working or the chat or anything, so I'm just going to have my fingers crossed and maybe you can just hear my voice, which probably, well, that probably is quite a bad thing, but we can see we're currently on board with Vodan. He's third. I'm not sure what times the guys have set so far. Let's have a look at the session info. So there we go. You can see Nick, Afro, Vodan, and Marek. They've all set times. We should be seeing the pole lap time in the region of a high 1 minute 45, I imagine, so shave about half a second, maybe a bit more, of Nick's time, then we might, then that will probably be what the pole time eventually is. You can see a lot of these drivers, you can see actually a couple of these drivers on the soft tyres anyway, so you know, it's not going to be that competitive. Let's go back to the live feed. So, let's see if we can find one of the top runners. Oh, well, it looks... let's go on board with Fizzy and see how he's doing. He's currently setting probably a high 29 per sector. No, it's a low 30. Not too bad. He's on the soft tyres, so clearly just looking for a bit of a banker lap. You know, it's always difficult going out straight onto the super soft tyres, especially around this track, when you know you might have quite a conservative strategy. So, for example, you're on F1 2016 for the restarts, you can choose between three tyre sets. You can have the sort of aggressive, the medium, and the not aggressive tyre strategies, and obviously depending on which one you choose, you'll have more of either the super the softer compounds or the harder compounds. Anyway, Fizzy is just coming towards the second sector around about now. It's a 48.9. Haven't done too much research. I've been quite busy trying to get a stream just sort of working, so I apologise for my lack of knowledge of the track. Coming up to the bus stop chicane road, braking at about 75 metres, a little bit of a lock up, not too bad. He hits the entry of both corners. And across the line, it's going to be a... ooh, it's not very good. It's only a 47.9. It could be better. I'm sure Fizzy will be looking for better. But he is, of course, only on the soft compound tyres. Let's have a look, see who else we can see. Here's Tirano Tigger, the current championship leader. Talking about a championship leader, let's just have a look at the driver standings. You can see Tirano Tigger is up there with 276 points. Behind him is Non-Runner, Fizzy Fan, Marco, Nooker, Race Fanatic, Nick B, Kalon, Raven, Marek, Chicane, Mini Black, Naily, Massachusetts, Randrop, and Nick No Name 777. Unfortunately, I can only get 16 driver names on my Drivers' Championship. So apologies about that. For the guys from 17th to 20th. Let's have a quick look at the Constructors' Championship. And you can see, well, really, Scuderia Ferrari are just sort of so far ahead. They're 180 points ahead of the next team, Renault. It's really quite incredible. Tirano Tigger seems to be on a lap, but it seems to be quite slow. Let's just have a look and see what if he's actually set a lap time by, if I can remember the controls. It says he's on, is that a flying lap? I forgot if that's a flying lap or not. No, he's about to cross the line and this is his flying lap. Continuing the Constructors' Championship, you've got Mercedes not too far behind Renault, and you've got Williams again not too far behind Mercedes, Red Bull not too far behind, Manor not too far behind Red Bull. Then you've got Toro Rosso, Sahara Force India, Sauber and McLaren Honda. Everyone seems to be in a fairly close proximity after Ferrari, but they really are running away with the team of Tirano Tigger and of Tirano Tigger and Marco are just flying away. Hello, is that Crazy? Hello, Crazy, how are you? Welcome to the stream. Hopefully everything's working okay. If you didn't see the Drivers' Championship, I just got put them up there. I'll also be showing the standings just before the race as well. Alright, Tirano's, he's got a 30.3. It's actually a little bit slower than Fizzy by point one of a second. Fizzy, of course, only set a 147.9 on the same tyres, though. Let's see, a 47.6. That's much quicker than Fizzy was in that sector. In fact, let's have a quick look and see what time Fizzy did actually set. Fizzy in the second sector, he set a 48.9. Tirano set a 47.6. That's a whole second, 1.2 seconds up. Really nice braking, hitting both apexes of the entrance and the exit. Coming across the line to set probably sort of a mid 46. Like I said earlier, we should be seeing high 45s upon. Let's go on to a different driver. I don't imagine Tirano will be setting another flying lap. However, he is giving it his all, so fair play to him. We've got Afro. Is he lagging a little bit? I thought he was lagging. Maybe it's not too bad. Might lose audio seconds as I exit out the game. You should still be able to see it, though. Oh, there we go, it's alright, and 46.7, not too bad from Afro. Not amazing, but not too bad. Again, he's on the soft tyre, so that is a pretty competitive lap time. I wonder if anyone's on the super softs. Odan is, but it looks like he's already set his lap. He's currently in 6th. Kalon, Marek's just set a lap time. He's put himself up into 2nd with a 146.5. Good job from him. I believe he came second last time out in Germany, did Marek, so he would have been very pleased with that. Fantastic performance, especially at his own home Grand Prix. I don't think we have any Belgium drivers today. Is it Belgium? I think it's Flemish, isn't it? I can't remember, although I know that's a language. So I probably offended loads of people, but it's okay. Tirano is going across the line again at 146.1. Very, very competitive indeed. That could be close to pole. We'll have to keep an eye on that, especially on the soft compound tyres. The reason a lot of these drivers are on the soft compound tyres is because it should be a one-stop, a one or two-stop race. The pit lane is about going to be, I think it's about 20 seconds long. So it is quite lengthy. Well, when I say it's lengthy, it's probably one of the shorter ones of the year. But yeah, you've got Mini Black, he's competitive time. So is Marek, all on the soft compound tyres. The highest super soft runner at the moment is Afro. I have to find out whereabouts he is in the championship, because I've got on a sheet in front of me, but I need to find his name. I can't actually see him, so is he new? I hope so, because otherwise that would be quite embarrassing. Nuka, he's a very much a split 2 veteran, now on split 1. Non-runner has retired from the race, wow, or qualifying. That's extremely surprising. That was not very quick at all, to be honest. He's only down in 6th, and that lap time, we should be seeing some drivers going quite a bit further up. Let's just have a quick look at the weather for the race. In fact, we should have a dry race. The last couple of rounds, we've seen wet races. Tirano Tigger is, well, obviously with those extra times, he's coming into the pits. Let's see if we can find a quick driver like Marco. He's on his outlap, so I definitely want to see him. He's on his outlap, but fairly competitive first and second sector times, to be fair, considering he is on an outlap. I imagine he is. Pretty quick. These cars, they get up to about 340 kilometres an hour down the straight. It's about, well, as you can see there, it's about 205 miles an hour, I think. But you can see Marco's managed to go 201. Let's see how he copes. So, he's looking for somewhere around the 30-second mark for the first sector. He's looking for a high 48-second sector, I think. I'm trying to get my facts right. Upper Rouge, incredible amount of G-force and downforce as the cars elevate themselves up there. DRS wide open. He's really shifting now. It's 215, 220 miles per hour. Incredible. Incredible top-end speed. In fact, that could be about 350 kilometers an hour. That is incredible. It's a 30.5. It's decent enough. It's not going to set the world alight. Let's have a quick look. See what the fastest is. So a 30, a 47.5 he's looking for. If you guys have any questions, please do feel free to put them into the chat, and because I can actually see it, so that's good. And also for live stream, for whatever reason, audio settings, well, I can't do much about picture quality because I'd have to stop the stream. But anything like audio settings, etc., please do say in the chat and I can adjust them as and when. Marco's got a 47.8, it's a little bit slower than a 47.5 is what he wanted. I'm interested to see what Nick has done, because he's got a very quick lap time. I think he's been put fourth. Of information telling me. Marco on the final home stretch, and it's a 47.1. It's seventh. It's not too bad. It's probably half a non-runner. No, it's just only just lower. Nick is fourth. Awesome lap time from him. Two purples. Oh, he did have two purple sectors until Massachusetts just beat him in the last sector. Fantastic lap time from Nick. He got a very quick first sector. It's about a tenth quicker than Tirano. That's nothing to be sniffed at. Marco looks like he's parking up, about to retire, unless he already has, and that's just my camera. That is quite an interesting line from O'Dan. He is on a super soft lap time. Is that going to be, like, this is his first super soft lap time? So let's see how he does it in the Force India. He's looking about a 30 flat, a 47.5 middle sector, and what's he looking for the last sector? He's looking for about a 28.5. In fact, he's not far off in the middle sector. In fact, he looks like he could be quite competitive. Look at all these drivers. Most of them are on the soft compound tyres. It suggests to me that Udan's pretty much forcing himself into a two-stop strategy. The rest are going to be trying a one-stop. And, oh, looks like we've just been kicked out. So let's keep an eye on Udan and see how he does. It's not too bad. He's 1.4 down from the leader. It's not brilliant. I was expecting a little bit more, considering he was so quick on his outlap. A little bit wide, using quite a lot of track. That's not a bad thing, though. He's going to shift down into sixth. Oh, no, into fifth, and then up, back up into sixth. We're going to have to see how he is on the second sector. Just coming up to it after the next couple of corners. Looking quite scruffy, to be honest. Got a lot of weaving. It says 1.4. I imagine that is incorrect. We'll see what he sets in a minute. I can look at the race director and tell you guys as well. He's quite low down, though, is Udan. So maybe that's not such a bad thing. His lap time's been invalidated. I thought he went a little bit wide. Let's see who else we can look at. Chicane, he's a really quick driver. And he's just came across the line. Right, looks like that's the end of qualifying. Let's try and get down. Where was Chicane? Ah, it's only 15th. It's a shame. Oh, well. Hang on. I think I need to quit. Can't hear any audio, so hopefully everything's still okay. Who are we waiting for? Fizzy, Nikki. Oh, well, apparently I'm ready. However, I might have messed up the procedure we normally do. Now, is there any way for me to... Right, there's actually no way for me to quit, so that's a shame. But what it means is that I'm gonna have to, I'm gonna have to quit at the beginning of a race and have my fingers crossed. Yeah, I'm just gonna have to have my fingers crossed. Don't think I can quit, unfortunately, in the formation lap. I know with King Kodiak, what we normally do is we both normally quit after qualifying. And then we rejoin, what allows you guys to see the formation lap. Unfortunately, it might have bugged me into doing the formation lap. Hopefully, there's not too many drivers behind me. I don't know how to look behind me, so... Right. If I quit now... I just need to check I have invites. I do have invites. So if I quit now...
Okay, go through all the gears if you can. We need to make sure the engagement is okay before the start. We're going to want to put some temperature into the tyres and brakes. We need to keep the engine cool, though, so don't go too high with the revs.
Yeah, well, I'm too bothered about that. Can I... I don't know if I quit. If I quit, I'm not sure if it's going to kick me, and that would be literally the worst thing ever. Should I just go, like... I don't even know how to change gear. This is bad. So, yeah, this is really bad. I now have to turn left and right, so, hey. I am using keyboard. Oh, here we go. God, I'm not very good. I apologise. I haven't used a keyboard in, well, since ever, really. Oh, God, this is awful. Can I just get DQ'd or something? Or maybe I can just get disqualified. This would be just fantastic. Okay, right, there we go. Wrong way, apparently. Well, while we're messing around here, let's have a look at the drivers' standings. If you guys weren't here at the beginning of the race, this is what they look like. You can sort of read through them. I've already read through them once, but you can really see that Toronto is... a league of his own above everyone else. It is quite phenomenal. It's one of the most dominant drives I've ever seen. It's very Marco-esque. If you ever followed Marco during like season 9 and 10 when I was racing, so it's sort of Marco ownage, Alex Gillen-esque. Bit of a fun fact if you didn't know, Marco has never lost a season in Split 1. He's never lost a championship. So he's a two-time or three-time champion, and he's never lost a championship. So this would be his first one, unfortunately, for him. Let's have a quick look at the constructors' standings. You can see there, Ferrari are just, completely dominating. So far above Renault, what is it, 180 points, isn't it? Yeah, it's absolutely crazy. Now, I've just got to make sure that I don't completely mess up. So I'm just going to have to pray to God that... Right, there we go. And retire from session. Here we go. Let's do that. Now, hopefully it'll send me... Ah, there we go. Right, here we go. On board with Tirano. Let's have a look closer towards the back. Looks like... let me take the standings away. Looks like there hasn't been too many disasters. Non-runner's gone down a little bit further, and considering he's second in the championship, that's a real big deal. Let's have a look closer up at the front. We've got Tirano. We've got Nick B, Marek, Mini Black, Massachusetts, Nicky. He got a good qualifying. I think he ended up in fourth. I might be wrong about that, though. So far, some pretty close racing. Tirano hasn't completely ran away on lap one. There's 22 laps. The cars will use up about 2.2 kilos of fuel. It's an extremely, it's at 70% full throttle. It is an extremely thirsty track. So these guys might have to do quite a bit of fuel saving. Unfortunately, we can't really see what fuel they're using. I know King Kodiak uses different cameras. Please do tell me if you want me to see outside camera views. I'm fine with that. F2. Yep, you guys obviously like to see this camera view. That is absolutely fine. I'll make sure I use that for the majority of the race. See, Tirano, he's got a bit ahead. Have a Nick B's right behind him. Nick B's had some really good performances, I thought, the last few rounds. He sort of started off like quite well. He got a fourth in the opener in Australia. He got a third place in Hungary. He got a DNF, unfortunately, in Hockenheim. And if I'm not mistaken, he got that really unfortunate glitch or whatever you want to call it. He just literally only just tapped the barrier, and that was his race very much over. So really unfortunate for him. I saw the replay and thought it was so unlucky. If I could award him points, I would do, because he hardly touched the barrier. In fact, the game just retired him. We got a really awesome fight with the Force India and Red Bull Racing of Marek, the German driver. Is he going to get another podium? He's been really strong since he's came into the season. Got a couple of the Sauber drivers behind as well. I mean, the DRS, I imagine, is going to be extremely, it is extreme powerful around here. The first medium runner, let me have a quick look at the race director. Hopefully it comes up. Okay, I can't view the race director apparently, which is like fine, I guess, but it's a bit annoying. Okay, I can't view the race director. Let's have a look. We're going to go on board who the medium runners are. Marco, wow, I think he's, has he got a bit of a jump at the start? I can't remember where he started. I can't remember where anyone started, to be honest. We have got a super soft runner, which is Afro. We saw him. We've got a fantastic move possibly coming up the inside with Nooker and Chicane. Isn't quite able to make it work. O'Dan is the first medium runner. He's definitely doing a one-stop. Did I say he was going to be doing a two-stop? I know he's going to be doing a one-stop with that. And so is Kaylee. He's also going to be doing a one-stop. We're back up with Tyranno. How far is Nick B? He's got DRS activated, not able to make it stick though. Mini Black has, in fact, where's Marek? Gosh, he's fallen well behind. He must have had some sort of issue. So that's really unfortunate for him. Anyway, he's, he's slowing down a lot, is Marek. Has he got a puncher? He must have a puncher or something, because he's just given another two positions away. What is it? Is it a front left? It is a front left or right? Probably a front right puncher. Really unfortunate. Not sure how that was caused. Let's go back up to the front. See Nick B and Tyranno. Tyranno isn't, damaged front wing apparently. Really unfortunate for him. Round a track like Spa with, well, it's actually a medium downforce circuit, this track. Or at least that's what it's classed as. You do need high downforce in some sections though. You know, it will really hurt you, especially around corners like Eau Rouge and, what is it, No Name? Oh no, Blanchimont I'm thinking about. Is Nick B going to be able to get any sort of move executed on Tyranno? We will find out as soon as they come up the hill of Eau Rouge. Incredible amounts of G. It's something like five G lateral or vertical even. Sorry. And it looks like he's not. Wow, what a camera view. Look at that. You see the helmet, the reflections. That looks amazing. Nick B isn't able to do anything about it. Possibly, you might be right. Maybe he was the first victim of Eau Rouge. We obviously saw Sebastian Vettel this year having an awful tyre blowout. It's obviously not as serious. We saw non-runner going very wide. We also saw Nick B going a little bit wide there. They're going to shift down into 5th or 6th gear, depending on how much fuel or not they want to save. It is a really difficult corner in this game. I remember when we... Spa was one of the beta testing tracks, and I remember when we first tested it out, and I had my wheel and stuff set up, how difficult it was. Like, you know, it took me a number of laps to get it right. These guys will not be going full throttle down Eau Rouge at the moment. Let's have a look at Mini Black. He's ain't much on his own, is Mini Black. Massachusetts, he's got his teammate Nikki right behind him. Is he going to try anything into the bus stop? Maybe he is. If he is, that would be a very brave move. He isn't. Let's go back onto Tyranno. In fact, no, let's go to Nick B and see if he's able to pull a move on Tyranno. Will we see a new winner in Apex Online Racing today? We've only had two winners so far. We've had non-runner with three wins, and we've had Tyranno with an incredible 9 victories. Absolutely insane. That is unbelievable. Really, in some ways, I know it's bad to say, but you almost hope that Tyranno gets a disconnect just so we can have a different winner. He is, of course, the veteran of PS4, an absolute legend on the PS4 side. He is a champ. He is an AOR champion in his own right on the PS4, not PC. Who knows, maybe he'll try and conquer Xbox next. Is that saying he gets this? No one's ever done that before. In fact, I'm not entirely sure how many cross-platform champions Apex Online Racing have had. Fizzy has obviously been on Xbox and PC. We've had another couple of drivers. I think Maisie CZ. We obviously have drivers like Ryan. He's cross-platform. I'm cross-platform, but not from AOR. I used to race on PS3. Uh, I don't know if Nick B will be saving. It's possible, because the fuel advantage from rich to lean is so big around here. It must be about, what, 7.5 tenths of a second from rich to lean, maybe even more. Their tyre compounds are exactly the same. You assume they've done the same amount of tyres. Maybe he's getting the DRS and then just cruising down the straight. You might be right, Toronto might have been on Xbox. I might have to do a little bit of research while the race is going on, see if he was on Xbox. I can't confirm either way. It looks like Nick's going to be too far behind. He has a good DRS though, so he is out that second, as you can see. It's 1.3 seconds, 1.7 now after that straight. Wow. Who knows, maybe he is fuel saving. Mini Black is probably catching up on Nick, actually. Wouldn't be surprised. Mini Black's on Nick. There's so many Nickies. Is there like 3, 4, 5 million Nickies in this lobby? Maybe we need to start calling them something else. Wow, look at this. There's two Sauber drivers that are so close, with the Williams of non-runner super close as well. How fantastic is that? Maybe this is going to turn out to be an incredible race. If Crazy's off to see how Marco's doing, he's currently in 8th. He's moved up from 9th, where he was at the beginning of the race. I mean, this is an awesome little battle at the moment. It's really close, so he could see the Williams go around the outside of Massachusetts. No, we don't. I apologize, guys. I'm actually looking up Toronto Tigger's former results and see if he was on Xbox. The person who mentioned it could very well be right. He would have been on Xbox in, what was it, like 2012 maybe, as far back as that. I assume he'd be on the F1 League. And obviously, Noble 2909 was. Nonva's having a bit of a tail happy car, and he's really messed up there. I can't see the results of Toronto Tigger. I'm not sure if he was an Xbox. He might have been though. He might have also been in another league beforehand. Again, I'm not sure. Apologies about that. Yeah, you're right, the Sambas should help each other with the slipstream. However, I think Nonrunner might be right back in it. Incredible. Maybe he's got some really good speed. Let's go back up to the front. Toronto still leading. Wow, look at that. Merrick from being third. He's now down to 17th on the hard compound tyres. How far behind is he from the leader? 43 seconds. Ouch. I mean, there's a possibility that he's going to gain, I don't know, maybe 20 seconds in a pit stop. I just want to check. Oh, sorry about the game being paused. I did get some insight earlier about someone. So it's only the insight I already know. Kaylee has left the session. That's really unfortunate. I'm not entirely sure where he was. Can we view the race director now? No, we can't. That must be an issue because we started the race, possibly. So unfortunately, I can't get all that insight from the race director. I should have quit and then rejoined, but hey, oh well. Toronto's coming across the line. Nick B is just falling back a little bit each lap. He's done 7 laps, or 8 laps, or yeah, they've completed 7 laps, and he's only 2.5 seconds behind. There's definitely still a race on. I wouldn't count him out just yet. Nick B is extremely quick, you know. I said earlier on, you know, he is a podium sitter in AOR. The next best spot would be second, but obviously after that, it would be the win. I just want to talk about, you know, some of the perhaps slightly more, at least for me, painful or disappointing drivers so far this season. It has to be Marco. He started off so well. He got a third and a second place. And it's just went downhill, you know, through bad luck, maybe lack of motivation. I know what it's like when, you know, it's when you've done really well, and then, you know, there's just a few races where you're not quite there. It's always difficult to keep going. I remember in season 9, I think it was, when me and Marco were winning in F1, you know, I think we locked out the first. We got the pole and the race win, and it was either Marco or me who won the races. And it was like that for the first sort of 7 races or something crazy like that. Marco went on to become the champion. I went on to get, I think, second, third or fourth in the championship. We didn't do too well. Towards the end, I missed a few races as well, due to just illness, holidays, family commitments and stuff. These Sauber drivers are putting on a great battle. It looks like Massachusetts just had a moment then. I keep hitting left and right to see the name, but obviously I can see it on top. And is not going to get a run down to the bus stop? It's a possibility. In fact, is Massachusetts going to get a run on his teammate? No, he's not. Nonrun has gone through. Massachusetts has gone wide. And Marco is also possibly going to pick up the pieces of Massachusetts. He's going to have DRS on the... what is it? Is it Camel Straight? I can't even remember. No, it's not Camel Straight. What am I talking about? The... straight. I forgot what the straight's called. How embarrassing. Oh well. Never mind. It's not too upsetting for me. And Marco is trying a move on Massachusetts. If Massachusetts hadn't made that mistake, he would still be ahead of Marco. Good move there by Marco. Next stop, non-runner. Good result for him so far. Fifth, I hope he can keep it up. We'll keep a close eye on this little battle here. Mini Black is also in ahead of these guys, not massively far ahead. In fact, and I've noticed that... who's pitted? Someone's pitted. One of the Sauber drivers have pitted. We're currently on Marco. Massachusetts, non-runner. Mini Black. Let's see if a Sauber driver. Ah, no, Nick's retired. That's the other Sauber driver. Really unfortunate for him. I'm not sure what the issues were. Hopefully I can get an update on the reasons for that. Toretto's still ahead. He's coming through the bus stop. I'm not sure what time that kind of lap these guys are pitting. But it's probably going to be around about 10, 11, or 12. I was reading one of the comments, I don't quite understand it, but oh well. We've got Mini Black in third. He's just 6 seconds behind the leader. Not too bad. And Nick is... He's only 4.4 behind Toretto Weaver. It'll be a soft medium strategy. Anyone on the soft tyres will be going on to the mediums, I imagine. Anyone on the super softs will probably do a double soft stint. I think the only driver who was on that tyre was, if I can find them, who was that? I think it might have been. Was it Kalon? No. Could have been O'Dan. No, I can't remember now. Who was on the super soft tyre? But they would have pitted now, actually. So, that Afro, he was on the soft tyre. He's now on the super... he was on the super soft tyres. He's now on the soft tyre. I've just received a message. Hang on, guys. I'm going to give King Kodiak the channel link, so if he wants to talk to you guys, he can. I'm just going to give him that link now. Uh, It looks like the two Ferraris have swapped position. Marco is leading. Didn't think I'd be saying that today. Oh, right, I see, right, okay. So he was saying big shot player. You could be right, he could have been big shot player. I remember JD, he's always changed names. He was... I thought he could have been big shot player. Oh, well, I'm not entirely sure. But Mark, he's now in second. Tirano's obviously on these fresh, hard compound tyres. I imagine Marco's going to be coming in this lap to pit. You've got Nick B. He's only 5 seconds behind. He's also pitted. He's on the soft, the hard compound tyres. Non-runner, he's pitted. He's in fourth. Good recovery drive so far. Obviously, he pitted very much on lap one. Good afternoon, King Kodiak. He has one of the greatest commentary voices of all time. Maybe we'll have to rate him as high as Murray. Alright, my era of AOR. Obviously, if not all of you will be aware, AOR did change ownership and it was quite concerning. I might even be able to remember the date. It was something like, it was 2013, it was January, whatever it was January the 14th. Of a year, I think it was 2013. I remember going onto the AOR site or ARL site, expecting. What was I doing? I was probably looking when our next league race was. You know, after Christmas break. Opened it up, and it said basically the site had been shut down and it wasn't going to exist. I remember like. Fizzy and all the other guys, you know, all the sort of the moderators and stuff, working absolutely crazy hard through that, you know. The fact that we had a full season of AOR that season, it would have been season 8, I think. Might have been season, no, it's season 7, wasn't it? I was in split 2 back then. Managed to work my way up to whatever split it is now, split 1. Well, I'm not in split 1 anymore. Tirano's still ahead. He's ahead of Nick B by 6.1 seconds. He's losing a little bit more time on these tyres. Non-runner is 15 seconds behind. We have Mini Black. He's very close. I imagine Mini Black's going to come on strong. Maybe he lost a position during the pits. Marco is in fifth. He's now pitted. Good job from him so far. Massachusetts, who made that mistake, who allowed Marco through on the straight after he, you know, got a bit tail happy on the bus stop. He lost that position to his teammate at the time, which was Nicky. Unfortunately, he's retired. A pretty close battle between those two. Going forwards onto Mini Black. He's going really close to non-runner. Is he going to have DRS? Probably. Maybe. Maybe. He's about 0.2 out at the moment. He's going to get the slipstream either way. Wonder if we can get that incredible helmet cam. I know. He's not going to get anywhere near. Halfway through the race. Let's go back on to Nick. He's only lost 0.1 of a second of that lap. He is close to Tirano. The race isn't over yet. If Tirano makes a mistake, Nick's going to be right back in this race. And I hope he is, because this is already his personal best race this season. Third is his best, as I've said before. Nonrun has done an amazing job to get back up into third. He qualified in 7th on it wasn't an odd strategy. He was on the soft compound tyres. He's already a three-time winner this season. He is one of the quickest drivers at the moment on PC, it must be said. Sorry. He is one of the quickest drivers on PC at the moment. He made that mistake at the beginning, dropping him down from 7th down to, what was it, like 9th or 10th or something. Clawed his way back up into 3rd. He's done some great overtaking moves. He's been fortunate for other people's misfortunes. But he's got Mini Black behind him, and they've been about this distance for the whole race. At least since he lost positions. Marco's in 5th. Massachusetts is in 6th. Lol. He's quite close behind Massachusetts as well. It's a pretty close race. It looks like we've got a bit more of a gap after that. We've got Kalon. We've got Marek. We've got Nooker. We've got some fantastic racing from Fizzy around the outside of the Toro Rosso of chicane. Great move. Mercedes got a little bit of oversteer, which is Nooker. Fizzy's going to have DRS. Let's have a look. This is for World Championship points. This is an important battle. Every point is better than not getting 1 point. But yeah, exactly, yeah. Probably should have faced it slightly different. Fizzy's right behind Mercedes of Nooker. He's not going to be able to make that move stick. Did Nooker have DRS? I'm not sure. Getting awesome view. Got the banana. He's wearing the banana helmet. Looks like Fernando Alonso-esque, that helmet. Not quite, but sort of Fernando Alonso-esque. If you look at it from behind, anyway. Marek's catching up with Kalon, I think. Quite good so far. Massachusetts. He's had a good race so far. I wonder what his previous results are. Fairly mediocre. He's a very much midfield. He got an 8th, a 6th, an 8th, and a 5th. He's only raced in 4 races. This is his 5th. So this is very much where he is strong. He's strong at the midfield. Mini Black is still right on the tail of non-runner. These guys really aren't losing that much time to Tirano. He hasn't got that ultimate and dominant pace. I'm not sure if he's saving tyres, saving fuel. But he might be doing a one-stop. It's possible. If you guys haven't seen, we're going to have a quick look at the Constructors and Drivers Championship. You can see currently. Just a refresh. We've got O'Darn. He's quite a while behind. So he's going to be getting lapped soon. Velocity. He's in 14th. Bit of a battle with Afro. Afro started on the super soft compound tyres. I don't think he's really been able to make that strategy work. It's unfortunate, really. I thought, you know, he could have been able to get a little bit further up the grid. Chicane, he's an AOR veteran. He probably knows every single move. He's probably done every single move. He's been mediocre this season. He's currently 11th. He has got a podium. He got that in Austria. But otherwise, he's been very much midfield. He's pretty much got points on every single occasion. Bar a couple. So, you know, that's quite good. So he's definitely sort of done himself justice. Fizzy, he's in that battle for 10th place. He really wants to get that, because as soon as he gets past Nooker, then he can have a look at Marek. He was really good. He was really competitive at the beginning of the race. He was 3rd. Was he 3rd? He's like 2nd or 3rd. In fact, looks like someone's going around the inside, which is Nooker. That looks like it's possibly position not done yet. Is it going to be a Verstappen? No, it's not a Verstappen. Is he going to get him into bus stop? Let's hope he doesn't outbrake himself like whatever driver was, a Sauber driver. Nick No Name, or Nicky, you might know him as. Nooker's gonna have another look at Marek. Oh, don't get too close, you might hit him off. Don't want that to happen. Now, Eau Rouge. This is a difficult corner, especially with Death's downforce being in the dirty air. Let's hope they both survive. It's extremely close. It's Schumacher and Häkkinen. Well, not quite. And it's a DRS versus non-DRS. And what a move. Fantastic move. Round the outside from Nooker. Great little move there. And Marek. Fizzy's the next one to scoop up that. And Marek could be out of luck and out of points. That wouldn't be good. Not for his championship anyway. I know he hasn't raced in too many, but he has been very competitive. Oh, I apologise. I've obviously spelt someone's name wrong on the standings. I apologise. I'm sure it's offended them. Not that I'm too bothered. Oops, wrong camera. Oh no, hang on. All the cameras are wrong. In fact, Nick B could be a little bit closer. No, he's still the same. 7.1. He's extremely quick, isn't it? I'm going to see if the race director works now. Unfortunately, I don't think it does. No, it just goes back to that screen. Non-run is sort of in a bit of no man's land with Mini Black. I mean, they've just been exactly the same. Marco, let's keep an eye on this gap. It's 22.2. And it's, what's that? Is that 18.1? It's 4 seconds. So if you guys can remember that for later on in the race, and then we'll come back to that. Massachusetts, Polish driver, he's on his own in no man's land again. Got Lol. And then we have a few drivers. We have Kalon, we have Nooker, we have Fizzy, and we have Chicane. Oh, his Mark is in the pits. He's came out with super soft tyres. You don't get any points for fastest lap, but that's what he's going to be going for with just 5 laps to go. Gosh, this race has flown by. Nooker right behind Kalon right behind the Mercedes of Nooker. Can he get any more points? Nooker's been in AOR for quite a while. He's been split two for a couple of seasons, I think. He's now in the top split and a very quick driver. You know, he's always consistent, is Nooker. He's only had one occasion outside the points, apart from his two DNFs, one in Baku, one in Hungary. Hungary was obviously a wet race. I can't remember what happened to him in Hungary. We did cover the race, though, me and Chris. Massachusetts, he's also quite close to Marco. Do you think he's going to be able to close in? Yeah, you're right, he was. Non-runner was originally in like 7th, 8th or 9th, I can't quite remember. And he's just had incredible pace. We didn't really see him because we were looking at the battle, because at the time, Nick B was very close to the leader. Tirano, of course, as always. And yeah, I'm not really sure. It must have been a bit of strategy. Maybe Mini Black, what car is he in? He is in the Force India. He could have had maybe pit stop issues. Maybe he changed like an end plate or something like that. Who knows? He could have got a puncture just before he came into pits. I saw that in Marek. He dropped down from second in the race. 18.1, 22.7. Still about 4 seconds. Tirano is very much, he's either controlling the pace or this is his pace. Maybe, in fact, Nick B has closed in. He's closed in by about 1 second. This might not be enough now. He needs to be closing in by quite a considerable amount. Mini Black will be really rooting and wanting this podium. He hasn't had a podium yet, has he? Oh no, he did get a second. Apologies, in Hungary. Which race did he crash out on? It must have been Russia where he crashed out on. Yeah, that's what I'm thinking about. So, Mini Black want another podium. He's currently 12th, you know, he's doing pretty well. Couple of no-shows. We tried to get Ryan in the stream earlier. Unfortunately, his game crashed. Really unfortunate for him. Would have been awesome to have him doing comms with me. I know, the Spa race is short. We got an even shorter race next time out at the Temple of Speed. Of course, I'm talking about Monza. A full race distance, a full Grand Prix distance, should take about 1 hour and 22. Hopefully me and Chris will be able to cover that together, hopefully with your highlights resumed as normal on King Kodiak's channel, or Ranger Carrot. It's twitch.tv/RangerCarrot. If you're new, make sure you go and follow him so you can see next week's race. Marco's lost a little bit more time though to Mini Black. I do think Mini Black's getting a little bit closer on to non-runner. He's only a couple of seconds behind. Nick B, let's have a look at a gap. 6.5. It's about the same. Let's have a look at this battle of Fizzy. Fizzy has overtaken Chicane for, in fact, actually no, he didn't overtake Chicane. He was always ahead of Chicane. So who's Fizzy overtaken? Maybe he did overtake Chicane. I can't remember. He's got Kalon next. Unbelievable. I can't believe King Kodiak has decided to promote his channel on our Twitch. That's absolutely devastating news to me. I'm the mods on that straight away. And a really nice racing between Kalon and Fizzy. Let's hope there's no collisions at the bus stop. Fizzy's sort of trying to switch back. You've got Chicane right behind him. Fizzy possibly trying to move down the inside into the first hairpin. That is, of course, the source. Fizzy's going to be getting DRS. It's very powerful. Around this track. 220 miles an hour as I go on to the cam straight or whatever straight this is called. And Fizzy has got the move around the outside, possibly. We're not going to see a Mercedes contact scenario, are we? No, we're not. It's okay. Chicane is coming hard back at Fizzy. Really difficult corner this. It's banked to the left. You start braking, then you start locking up, then you get a little bit of oversteer, you get the car mid-corner, able to turn it in, use the downforce of the car. So it's good to have your ballast a little bit forward around this track, because it just really helps in corners like that one. What's it called? Riviege or something like that. Oh, Kalon's gone a little bit wide. Fizzy's right behind him. A bit of a sort of a top-down camera angle. We haven't got any... haven't got any helicopter cameras, but it doesn't matter. Fizzy's got around the outside. Kalon, what were you doing leaving the door open on the inside? Can't believe it. Devastating for him. Fizzy's got P9. He's had a good season, hasn't he? I think he's company third in the championship. He's got four podiums. He's sort of been... I just find it strange with Fizzy. He's the cleanest driver you're ever going to get. He's probably never put all four wheels outside of the white lines. And, yeah, you know, his performances are always quite... they're always quite sort of... mediocre. He's not that consistent. He is an extremely quick driver though. We've seen you don't get onto split one and Xbox for nothing. I mean, you know, who knows? If some of the drivers such as Matt, Harry, JD weren't racing. Obviously we also had people like Maisie, TraceMe92, all those drivers who were just so quick on the Xbox League who are no more. You had the TRL guys, of course. Let's leave gap. What is it? It's 7.4. It is. I think Tirano's just controlling the pace. It's unfortunate, but it is what it is. We had a helicopter cam there and a marker there. So he's lost a little bit of time. He's now 5 seconds behind Mini Black. He's got to be careful, though. Massachusetts doesn't get him. Massachusetts is getting very close. And Lowell is also quite close in the other Williams. Williams, of course, doing quite well in the Constructors' Championship. Well, I say they're doing well. They're in fourth. Then a brilliant little battle with Renault, Mercedes, and Williams. Mercedes and Renault. And even Red Bull are quite close. And even Manor. I mean, the points difference from second down to sixth is just so close. So you've got Mercedes are just 35 points behind Williams. Williams are 20 points behind Mercedes. Red Bull are 11 points behind Williams. Manor are 2 points behind Red Bull. Pretty close. Should be quite exciting, really. I mean, Ferrari have got the championship. It's the only thing Ferrari are going to win this season, because they're probably never going to win anything again. I saw something on my screen. Don't know what that was. Someone retired, probably. Maybe. I don't really know, to be honest. To be honest, I'm not very good at like commentary. I just sort of blabber on about things which are completely irrelevant. But one thing isn't irrelevant. Tirano Ticker has 10 Grand Prix victories. He is your winner of the Belgium Grand Prix. Awesome result by... I don't know who that was. Non-runner next. Mini Black after that. Nick B, great result from him. He got second. Marco, he's going to get fifth. I think he's going to be not disappointed with that. He didn't start off too well. In seventh, got Massachusetts. Lol coming up in seventh. Nooker in 8th, he's in no man's land, coming up to the bus stop. Wow, look at this, gonna have Merrick. Fizzy's lost a position, Merrick's got him, he's locked up, Fizzy's gonna get P10, maybe, possibly, we have no idea. Incredible, we've got Chicane, Fizzy and Merrick. There's some debris on the road. That was incredibly close, what a race. What a finish for 10th. Important. Well, we got Chicane, he's in 12th, so good for him. Afro, he stuck it out. I wonder if he did end up getting the fastest lap. I'm not sure. And Afro comes across the line as a 13th driver to finish. Nick B, lucky non-runner wasn't too much closer. He got a 3 second time penalty. Got Mini Black, you can see. I mean, a lot of these drivers moved up, apart from Marek, who moved down. Mini Black moved down from third. He wouldn't have been pleased with that. Wow, Fizzy starting 16th, up into 9th. Awesome result for him. Nooker started 10th, he's in 8th. Lawlaw got an awesome result. He's in 7th, he started in 12th. Marco moved up 3 positions. Chicane moved up from 15th. Not that it was difficult. Afro, he went down, unfortunately. Nick No Name, or Nicky, really unfortunate. He had an issue, which I apologise, I can't remember. And then I didn't get any points at all. Maybe one day the Haas team will get points. Well, that has been it, guys, for this race. I hope you guys have enjoyed the stream. It's not quite as professional as what's the Midjiggy? Ranger Carrot, Chris. And hopefully, you know, it's allowed you guys to at least, if nothing else, to see the race. Thank you very much for watching. And you'll be sure to see me and Chris next week on Sunday at the Temple of Speed in Monza. Ta-da, and bye-bye.